polynomial, yes, the given polynomial becomes 0. The meaning of 0 is the value of x at which the px becomes 0. Okay, now, we are considering exercise 2.2. First question, find the value of the polynomial, that is a polynomial 5x minus 4x square plus 3 at different values. Here the values is given, first part is x is equal to 0, second one is that x is equal to minus 1, and third one is that x is equal to 2. Now we will start the solution of the given question. In place of x, we will put bar, that is pt is equal to 2 plus t plus 2t square minus t cube. Yes, that is a particular polynomial which is given in the question. Again, in the same way, we have to find out first p0. Yes, so we will put t is equal to 0 in place of t. 0 plus 2 square and 0 cube. It will be 2 plus 0 plus 0 minus 0. So that will be answer is 2. Again, we will put that value at p 1 of that particular polynomial. So we will put the value 1 in place of t. Minus 1. Okay. 2 plus 1, 3. 3 plus 2, 5. 5 minus 1 is equal to 4. Now, at t, 2 also we have 2. So, in place of t, we will put 2. So, it will be 2 plus 2 plus 2. Here, 2 square. And then, 2 cube. Again, 2 plus 2. 2 is a 4, 2 is a 8. And 2 cube is also 8. It is plus, it is minus. Cancel off and the answer is 4. So this is all about the question number 2, second part. Now come to the third part of question number 2. The polynomial is px is equal to x cube. In the same way, we have to find out first p0. So in place of x, we will put 0, which is equal to 0. In the same way, we will find out p1. Yes, in place of x, we will put 1, which is 1 cube. 1 cube is always 1. In the same way, we will find out p2. In place of x, we are going to put 2. That is 2 cube. 2 cube is always 8. So, this is all about the third solution. Question number 2. Now, student, come to the fourth part of question number 2. Yes, again, we will find p0. So, it will be 0 minus 1 and 0 plus 1. Yes, 0 minus 1 is always minus 1 multiplied by 1. So it will be minus 1. Then p2, which is equal to 2 minus 1, 2 plus 1. We have find out p2 first. Yes, I know that we have to find out first p1, we will solve afterwards. So it will be 1 into 3, which is equal to 3. And p1 I am finding here. Yes, p1 is 1 minus 1 and 1 plus 1. So 1 minus 1 is 0 multiplied by 2, which is equal to 0. So this is all about the fourth part of question number 2. Now student, we have done question number 1, question number 2. Now we'll come to the question number 3. Verify the following are the zeros of the polynomial. It means that we have to put the values which is given in the question in Px. Then we will get answer 0. It means that the particular value of x is the zeros of that particular polynomial. So let's start the question. So p, in place of x, we are going to put minus 1 by 3. So let's put the values 3 minus 1 by 3 plus 1. As it is in the multiplication, so 3, 3 will get cancelled off. It will be minus 1 plus 1. come to the fifth part. So P0, so it is understood 0 square is always 0. So yes, x is equal to 0 is the 0 of the given polynomial. 0 of given polynomial. Similarly, we can do the sixth part also like that. Yes, I move to the sixth part. Dx is equal to Lx plus m at x is equal to minus m by l. So p minus m by l, which is equal to l. In place of x, we put m by l plus l. As we will get cancelled off, minus m plus m. This minus is positive, so we will get 0. So yes, x is equal to minus m by l is 0 of the given, is 0 of given polynomial. Okay, now we come to the seventh part. So, one by one, we will take first minus 1 by 3, which is equal to 3 minus 1 by root 3 square minus 1. Yes? Now 3. That is a minus sign, but the power is given, it will become plus. And root 3 square is always 3 minus 1. 3, 3 will get cancelled off. 1 minus 1, which is equal to 0. So p minus 1 by 3 or x is equal to 1 minus 1 by 3 is the 0 of the given polynomial. Now p 2 by 3. Again we will put p 2 by 3 in the same equation. Yes, that is 3, 2 by root 3 square minus 1. So here it will be 3, 2 is a 4, 3 minus 1. 3, 3 will get cancelled off. It will be 4 minus 1 is equal to 3. So, student, x 2 by 3, x equal to 2 by root 3 is not a 0 of the given polynomial. Yes, it is not equal to 0. So, p 2 by root 3 is not equal to 0, therefore x is equal to 2 by root 3 is not a 0 of the given polynomial. But come to the 8th part, at x is equal to half, we have to find out, so p 1 by 2, which is equal to 2, 1 by 2 plus 1. Yes? So now, 2 just add it. Okay, now p half we have to take. Yes, so it will be 2, 1 by 2. We are putting the value of x as half and then plus 1, which is equal to 2, will get cancelled off. 1 plus 1, which is equal to 2. So, as it's not equal to 0, therefore 1 by 2 is not the 0 of the given polynomial. Okay, now student. Now, to question number 4, find the zeros of the given polynomial. Yes? Find the zeros means we will put px is equal to 0. Indirectly, we have to find out the values of x. So, when px is equal to 0, it means that x plus 5 equal to 0. Okay? So, x is equal to minus 5. So, minus 5 is the 0 of that given polynomial. In the same way, we will move to the second question. Px is equal to x minus 5. Again, we have to find out the zeros. We will put px is equal to 0. So, what is px? X minus 5 equal to 0. So, x is equal to 5. So, x is equal to 5 is the 0 of that given polynomial. Now, come to the third part. Px is equal to 2x plus 5. Again, px is equal to 0. Therefore, 2x plus 5 equal to 0. Therefore, 2x is equal to minus 5. So, x is equal to minus 5 by 2. So, x is equal to minus 5 by 2 is the 0 of the given polynomial. Okay, now come to the fourth part. That is, px is equal to 3x minus 2. We have to find out the 0. Therefore, px is equal to 0. Now, 3x minus 2 is equal to 0. Therefore, 3x is equal to 2. So, x is equal to 2 by 3. It means that 2 by 3 of the given polynomial. Now again, px is equal to 3x, which is equal to 0, therefore x notebook. Now share, subscribe our channel.